for practically all ants, only a proportion of the colony leaves the nest in order to forage, and they bring back the food for everybody else. So one of the measures that one would like to take, one should take, is how many foragers does this colony have? So the real expert in doing these mark recapture studies is actually my former student and colleague, Christina Kwapich, who is going to give you the details of the method and maybe some other intelligence about that method.
So today, we're just going to capture as many workers as we can from the surface, and that will give us an idea of the population that comes out onto the surface each day. And we can follow that population through time with multiple mark recaptures. So what I'm going to begin doing is using the trusted DeWalt vacuum to collect and count foragers as I do it. Now we're going to get a look at our 300 ants. Now we're ready to mark our ants, and we use a fluorescent printer's ink diluted in ether. We use about 20% ink by volume in the ether. So we put our ink and ether into a disposable atomizer, and basically we take our ants and apply three or so sprays. And so now they should all be adequately marked, and they'll be marked for the rest of their lifetime. It's been 24 hours after we released the ants that we marked. We come back and collected another 300 ants from the surface of the colony. And now, looking at them under black light, we can see that approximately 50% are marked with fluorescent orange ink. Based on our captures of 300 on day one, 300 on day two, and 150 marked ants, we can say that the total forager population size of this nest is approximately 600 ants.
A colony has a fixed amount of labor available to it in the form of the bodies and behaviors of its workers. So how a colony allocates that labor to different kinds of tasks is really important and is clearly a highly selected attribute